almost welcome to crazyforveggie.com. Now today I'm going to make a strawberry blueberry jam, and because you know the season is going on for strawberry and blueberry, and I really like this jam with my homemade biscuit, so that's why I'm going to make this. So this is like, you know, around like 20 to 22 medium strawberry, not too big, not too small. And this is a 1.5 cup of blueberry, and rinse thoroughly both, and you know, cut this strawberry into like small chunks, and cook this both together. Keep your flame on medium, and let it cook. I'm going to cover this, and we have to let it cook until, you know, strawberry start to leave its moisture, both strawberry and blueberry. So it's been like 15 minutes, and you know, when it started to shimmer, I, you know, uncover my pot, and I keep my flame a little bit on a high side, and then I keep stirring this, and you can see that the consistency of it, and still it has so much moisture, but that's okay, because I want it to be like that. And now at this point we are going to add a sugar into it. So add the sugar. Now, you know, taste it before you are adding a sugar, because some strawberries are, you know, so tangy in its taste, but some are naturally so sweet. So definitely you need to taste it before you are adding a sugar to it. Now mix it well, and we have to keep stirring it until, you know, it's almost evaporated its moisture, but you know, I want it to be like quite liquidy, not too kind of, you know, jam consistency. So that's why I'm not going to burn my moisture so much. Now one more tip, that you can, you know, drop some lime juice into it. So by that, you know what lime juice does, that it helps to create the jam texture in it. It will help to binding your jam. So if you want to bind it, definitely you have to add some drop of lime juice to it. Now again, I'm going to keep mixing it, and I'll show you, you know, how it will turn out when it's done. Hey friends, so I just turn off my stove before like 2 to 3 minutes, and you can see the consistency of our jam. It is not like too thick but not too thin, and you can see the texture of a blueberry and a strawberry in it. So definitely I want this texture, but if you don't want it, you can simply blend it. That's a perfect too. So yeah, one more thing, when it will cool down, it will thicken up a little bit. So yeah, that's for the note, you know, when you are making this. So now I'm going to let it cool down, and then after we are going to, you know, store it in a airtight glass container. So how was it? I really wish you liked my this recipe of strawberry blueberry jam. Stay tuned with my more recipe. All the detailed ingredients are there on my site at www.crazyforveggie.com. See you next time. Till then, take care.